like clearly show you that the building is falling apart even today. The buildings are opening, the walls, and the dome is falling. That's why as soon as they completed the building, they built these ones. These are supporting the walls, all four sides, because the building was opening like a flower and the dome was falling. In order to stop it from falling, they built all these supporting walls. And when did we take Istanbul? The Turks, Ottomans, Muslims. Come on, you have to know this. In Turkey, if you want to be a hacker, half the Turks use this as their password. 1453. 1453. My father, my mother, everybody's telephone code. If you want to know, this is 1453, because this is a very important date in our history. This is when we conquered Constantinople. Everybody wanted this city. Outside the church, I mean, this is now a mosque and this is now a museum. I will show you the hadith of the Prophet ﷺ that made armies of Muslims for centuries come and siege this city, starting from the time of Umar and Muawiyah and all the others. So the Constantinople, which is the name of the city, he said the Constantinople will be conquered one day. What a beautiful commander is the commander, and what a beautiful soldiers are the soldiers. So everybody wanted the city, all the Muslims. And it wasn't until Muhammad al-Fatih, Mehmed II, at the age of 21, conquered this city. And today, when I take you to Topkapı Palace, I will show you the exact spot and exact strategies that he used. So then he comes, the city is taken on a Wednesday, and this is a church, and the Friday prayer is done here. And it was converted into a mosque very quickly. They built a wooden minaret. I mean, from the other side, you see the spot, actually, they made a little tower and a wooden minaret, and then they did the Friday prayer here. As soon as they were leaving the prayer, and Fatih Sultan Mehmed said, build some madrasas around. Education was immensely important for him, so they started to build other buildings around Hagia Sophia. Over there, we have a soup kitchen. On the other side, there is a primary school. Madrasas around are demolished, they are gone, and the Turkish government now has a project to rebuild those madrasas, because they are the first educational institutions in the empire, in Istanbul. And then it became a mosque for like five centuries after that date, until 1930. And then we have the revolution, we have the reform, republic comes, and this building was turned into a museum.